In this video, I will check some new models for colorization that can give locally fast and rather good results, the DDColor models. To go one step further, I will also mention and compare some other methods and models, some of which will be paid online services. One will be the Photoshop Colorize Neural Filter method, one ControlNet ST 1.5, and one ST Accelerate Color method. This mention will come first, and then I will talk and compare some of the results with the DDColor ones. So if you want to skip ahead, use the timestamps of the chapters in the description below. There you will also find links and more info. Let's start with the fact that colorizing a black and white photo with AI cannot be 100% accurate. Here I converted to grayscale and recolored with DDColor some of my photos and I rated the result. So the question is, with what software, which means a method and some trained AI models, we can have the results that we like the most when colorizing a black and white photo? Even though I do not understand the exact method that DDColor achieves the automatic colorization of black and white images, I have an idea and that is enough for me. To achieve colorization, there has to be a trained process that will teach a model that certain parts of the photo are usually colored with a certain color palette. So the sky and sea is mostly blue, people's skin can have variations of a certain palette, tree barks have a different color than leaves, and so on. Colorizing is a form of reimagination of the photo, and it creates a colored version of what the photo is depicting. So AI methods must first identify objects, persons, skin and clothing, landscapes elements, walls, rocks, etc., in order to feed them to a model in order to predict their color with the given information that the model has. What the model has available is light-related information only, and with that, it has to produce the hue and saturation from it. I chose a couple of paid online colorize services just to have a reference of what those services offer in terms of quality. Palette FM did impress me with the variation of color palettes and the accuracy of the image interrogation even with low quality photos. I liked a lot that you are able to see the text of what is recognized from the photo, since it can be an indication of what the model finds difficult to distinguish and colorize from it. If the figure of a person is so blurred, then the model will not colorize the skin properly. In this photo, Palette did a better job than DDColor models. Photoshop colorized it though sufficiently. You need to register to test out more than a few images, but it lets you download the result in low resolution and with a noticeable logo on the bottom right of the photo. I did come back to Palette to check it when other methods were finding difficult to colorize certain photos, and I can definitely say that it is the best of the ones I tested for the purposes of this video. However, is it worth it for me that I have access to free alternatives in Photoshop? For now, no. The rest of the three, Image Colorizer, Deep AI, and Hotpot AI Colorize, did not stand out for me. The few photos I was able to test with their demo, free plan, I was not getting results that intrigued me to test the services more. With Hotpot AI at least, I was able to colorize photos freely to low resolution outputs to test it a bit more. Just for a quick comparison, Hotpot AI, that offers a bunch of AI services, charged 25 credits to colorize a full resolution photo. For $10, you can buy 1000 credits, which means 40 photos per month, which of course is $120. Palette FM has a yearly plan for 480 photos for $72, which is significantly cheaper. The per month price is $9, or $108 per year, which is closer to the Hotpot AI service. Adobe has introduced an AI recolor in Photoshop that can be found in Neural Filter's dialog box, where you have several options on what to produce with this process. Being able to produce a color layer is great when you want to fine-tune a good result. However, many times the results are not so good and you need to make changes that cannot be done in a color layer. So making a new layer and trying the changes there is the way to go. Being able to produce colorized outputs with alternative methods, with other software, in order to add them as layers in Photoshop many times is very handy. There are times that I will composite color information from Photoshop method and from other sources, when Photoshop gives good results in a particular area of the photo but fails in other areas. There are methods that can be used with the automatic 1111 control net and the Stable Diffusion models 1.5 and Excel. These methods use the respective recolor models and our IOC lab and a recolor model of the STXL-based checkpoint. The only way that I have found that works in order to colorize a photo with these methods is by using ControlNet in the Text-to-Image tab. I will need to manually put the output dimensions in order to be identical as the source black and white photo, or at least the width and height of the output image has to be of the same aspect ratio. What I found making this video is that the text prompt will affect the colorization process. That makes sense, of course, but until now I was using this method by disregarding it altogether. That opens up more possibilities for creating colorized versions, to input layers in Photoshop to produce better outputs. Using Realistic Vision version 6 as a checkpoint for this photo produced great results. The main disadvantage of this method, I would say that it is time-consuming compared to other methods of coloring. To produce 4 alternatives with the LCM method and with Realistic Vision, it took almost 10 minutes. With the other methods, a couple of seconds are enough to produce one. For the Excel model, it took 3.5 minutes using the LCM method and 8 steps, and when trying without LCM, 33 steps, and it took 16.5 minutes, but the result was quite better, and the best that I got from this photo. Having these methods to try them, when the other that I have available fail, is a good tool to have. Now finally for the DTColor models. I use them in Comfy UI software by adding a custom node with the help of the manager. These DTColor models are 4 different ones that will be downloaded automatically when you first use one in the Comfy UI interface. You can also check the details in Hugging Face page, from where you can also download them and find the link of the paper that describes the method in depth. The workflow is basic, and it only has a source image, the DTColor node, and an output preview image. I have pasted the node 4 times in order to be able, in each node, to have one of the 4 different DTColor models. Most of the time, the best results are from the artistic model, but there are exceptions and that's why I keep running them all. At the same time, this process only requires a couple of seconds, making the method quite convenient. I have already tested the models with dozens of photos, and the results are satisfying. Sometimes the outputs of some particular black and white photos are not colored at all, and I try to overcome this by trying to improve them in Photoshop and then fit them again in the workflow. This process works sometimes, but then again sometimes it does not. This is why having alternatives to try to colorize a photo is useful. Here you can see the attempts to colorize this particular photo, the method used, and the time taken for the generation. Keep in mind that for the recoloring times, I have a 3060 NVIDIA graphic card with 12 GB of RAM. These are the photos that Palette.fm has the better chance to colorize among the rest of the methods and the tools that are tried. Photoshop Colorize is not the best, but if you have a subscription, it is worth checking it out, since some photos it can produce acceptable results. From the few paid services that I have tried, PalletFM is the one that I would do some further research on if I was interested in colorizing images and did not have access to free tools and methods. The controlled models can be a valuable option to try the results on black and white photos that other methods fail to produce a good outcome. Finally, for the Digicolor models, they are definitely worth checking them out, as different source photos may give different results, and having alternatives that also can produce the outcome fast is useful.